Hello everyone, and welcome to the ACMG tutorial for making a top-down adventure shooter. I previously made a lot of assets and stuff in the first part of this video, and they were very, very helpful for what's about to happen. So in the last one, I made the player so that he can shoot, he can lay down mines, and then those trigger explosions. Mines can be destroyed by bullets, all that fun deal. Added some cursor sprite for this, so left-clicking shoots, the player follows the mouse, and then he drops a mine when you right-click. And the mines will automatically go off as well. So if you guys jumped straight to the second part, you know, because you're curious about what the video game is looking like, this is what it looks like so far. And so we're going to be working on adding some collision to the map, giving the player, you know, some stuff to destroy, and then adding an enemy, and then create a video game from there. So this is pretty much what the video game's about. Let's continue on. What is this? No. Stop. Stop it. No. Stop giving me errors. I don't like errors. Alright, I may have to close it down and reopen it. I don't know what's going on. Go. Honestly, it would have scared me if it just destroyed everything. Make sure everything's here. Okay. Gosh. I was gonna say all that work. Okay. Oh, gotta make the cursor persistent, huh? Did that. Go ahead and add some collision for the level building and stuff. So this object collide, what's going to happen is when it loads up, it's not going to have any visibility. So player can't see it, but it's going to be like on top of everything. Actually, no, it's going to be beneath everything. I don't even... I like all the nines, but that works too. That's a lot. Okay. So we'll just make it so the player, when they collide with a block, we'll just send them backwards. So, see what this is. This should make it so it just, you know, stops when it's colliding. Gosh, if I know if it's gonna work. It's worth a shot though, right? So this is the object collide. Oh, it's so hard to find out where they are. That's what I don't like. Let's see how far down this tile is. It's 1,000,000. So, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so this should work. Oh. It slows him down. We'll work with it. Contact solid. I'm not using speed, so I just need him to stop. Let me see. Yeah, okay, the move contact solid definitely only works with like platformers, which is a really good thing. Let's do something else. Okay. I use this in my other one as well, inside of the Elite. This is just the same exact thing that I use. All it is it's a collision check. So I'm gonna leave this up here for a second in case you need to copy it. Pause the video, take the code. What this does is sets a variable of the direction that the player is going, and then if it's in contact with this object, which I put it in the object collide, and all it does is it checks for that X and Y of the player to this, and then it stops it based on where it's at. This should work. If not, gotta look again, but this is what I use in my other game. Okay. Might help if I do this. Alright, so the player can't move outside of it. And I'm really gonna try it, but hold on, so. I'm gonna try that move contact solid thing. I totally forgot they're not solids, so just phasing through. Yeah. That works too. If you want to one-line it, you can one-line it. It's a little bit buggy. That's why it's difficult to use. But it works. And if that works, actually, I'm just not even going to bother with this next one. So, move contact solid works. Let's see how buggy this one is real quick. So it's about the same. Let me add 2 to this. Lot of testing. Yeah. Oh. Did get stuck a little bit. Change that to 5. I'll tell you the final one if I get it working, you know, just peachy. So, you can go with the move contact solid. I'm totally going to go with the var direction. It's just a lot smoother. And you can change these variables here, which is the -1, -1. You can change those to however close you want it to actually be to that wall. Obviously, I'm choosing -1. Alright. Oh boy. Now that we got all that done, I'm gonna go ahead and start adding in some level building items such as boxes and, you know, the crates that I have. This will be breakables for the player. I'm gonna do something for when the box breaks. So I'm gonna steal some of this stuff out of here. what I'm doing here is I took a piece of that wooden box, and I'm going to use it whenever these boxes are broken. It's going to explode using this. And so it'll fly out in a random direction or whatever on the ground. And I'm going to do the same thing to this one too. This is a gray piece. Make sure I got it in the right center. Okay. And then all the green in this box explode. Or something, I don't know. I'm calling something cool. Let's go ahead and create our first box for testing. So I'm going to create these simultaneously together. I'm going to change this music. But I'm going to create these simultaneously together. This is going to be the box piece that's going to be thrown out. This is the box that the player's going to be able to explode. And these are not going to be solid. But when it gets created, it's going to throw it into a random direction. We're gonna add some friction to this too, so it slows down. I think 0.2 works. And then when the alarm gets set off, it's gonna destroy. Let's give it some time to settle. So, 35. Oh, you know what? How about this? We'll give the boxes some health. Say, 3 health, 3 hits from a bullet, or 1 hit from an explosion. I'm not sure. I don't remember if the equals is in this one or not. So many different languages that are up in my head. Alright, so if the P health, it's going to create the box piece and then destroy. this box. And eventually, we'll want to have it give loot. So, it'll give its loot. I gotta learn to spell, guys. Come on. And then we're gonna create the box piece. Which I don't think I have saved yet. It's totally not. Oh, it is called Brown Piece. Alright, we're good. Alright, and I totally got rid of the collision events. My bad. Alright, so when he gets hit by this, we'll just subtract the health. So, P health minus equals 1. And if he gets hit by an explosion, minus equals 3. Oh. Which reminds me, if it takes more than that damage, so it needs to be less than or equal to 0. So it doesn't matter if you put equal. I'm just going to copy over the code, put a minus 3, save this bad boy, make sure everything is all good to go, and let's go ahead and add a box to the level. Oh yeah, and we got to make those objects spin too. These brown pieces need to spin. So it needs to choose a direction, it needs to choose a speed, it needs to also choose an angle. And we're going to do a random 360, so it's going to be like, blah, just all over the place. And we have to actually choose how many we spawn, so when it gets destroyed, I don't want it to just create one, I want it to create 6. So I'm going to write a script really quick that does this. So in the scripts, we're going to create a script named str box explode, and we're gonna throw in some arguments here. I don't think I've actually gone over how to create scripts. So what happens is we use arguments in the scripts, like argument 1 or 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 all the way up to like 13 or something or 15, and we pass in these arguments that we can use inside the script, and I'll show you how that works. So just name what this is, we're gonna talk about what this does. And then we're going to add in what these arguments do is which box. Actually, let's do X, Y, which box. And then how many? Now we got a for loop. X 0. X is less than argument 3. Put some spaces in here. In the right spaces. I'm going to actually use I, because x is an argument. So for I equals 0, I is less than argument 3, which is how many boxes need to be created. We're going to do I plus plus. So we're going to create an instance for each one of these boxes. So it's going to create a box piece that's going to fly out. Pretty simple. And so in order to call this, we just call that script name and fill in the arguments. Really easy. And it looks super awesome when it happens. So So we can go SCR, box explode, and we're going to be calling in this X, this Y. It's going to be object box brown piece, and then let's go ahead and just screw it, let's do 10. Let's see if this works. It's quite a bit of code in just a little bit of time, so let's see if it works out. You know, let's play some mine here. Yeah, do you see how that happened? 1, 2, 3. Beautiful. So the bullet's obviously not destroying it, but you saw what happened. That was amazing. So let's put this to 0.5. I love what just happened there. It is super beautiful. I need the bullet to disappear whenever it hits a box, though. So whenever it collides with a solid, I'm just gonna destroy it. So that was beautiful to me. I liked what just happened. I was very entertained. So I'm gonna shoot it. There's 1, 2, 3 shots. 1, 2, 3 shots. And then, oh, that's might be a problem. I can't strafe through here, which might be a problem. So I'm gonna edit the mask on this a little bit. Just gonna lay mines around here. I'm gonna work on that little collision issue there. I like what happened. Those boxes, that makes me happy. They might be flying a little too far, so let me speed a random of, let's do 6, so they don't go too far. And, man, this collision thing. I don't know what this -4 is going to do. Collision's a little buggy. That's really fun. Okay. Let's see if I can mess this collision a little bit. How about -0.5? I don't want him to like bounce. Like that's not good. Gotta give him a little ways to work with it. Let's go ahead and modify this mask and give it just a little bit more. This Independence Day song, jeez. Maybe it's not in the box, but it's in the player. No? Precise. Oh gosh. I don't know, I'm gonna do a precise one. See what that'll look like. Usually it's not good at all. Just so buggy. Okay, I like it, except I just noticed something, that when this box explodes, it needs to be placing, plus sprite width, it's 16 on both sides, because it's 32 by 32, and I want it in the center of the box. I noticed they're, like, exploding on the other side, and I was like, that's not right. So like, 2, 3, yeah, there we go. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right, I can go ahead and start adding the other boxes. Let's duplicate. This will be box 2, which is the exact same thing. This is box 3. Which is a green box, and I don't think this should be explodable. Just have more health. Looks good. Object, box, green piece. Yep. This one's gonna be the gray piece. Alright. So I have all the pieces for the box. Extra health. It's a great piece. Yeah, that's right. I yawned. Box 5. And And this one does create gray pieces, but it also explodes. So it can cause more. This is the object explosion. So, for instance, you put it in the middle of something and it'll explode all the boxes around it. So, I can show you that. This is what's cool about creating your own games. You can do whatever you want. And I'm just adding my own little flair to it. So I just like, boop, put a mine there. Should destroy that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. Oh wait, there's gonna be more mines. Boop, boop. Haha. So, yeah, that box is OP. Let's see, box 6. It's broken. I don't know. Wait. Has too much health? Has 1 health? And you never find anything in it. Because it's already been broken. And there's only like 3 pieces that fall off of it. Because we can do that. And then I think there's one more box. Yeah, box 7. And this one should just be your standard everyday box with a lot of health. And why not? We'll give it more pieces to drop. And explosions don't work on this one. So just do a test room of all of our boxes. You know, I'm gonna end up spending all my time doing this. Just messing with boxes. Obviously, I'm going to set up mines all over the place. Yeah! So cool. Blow up already. I like it. I'm enjoying this whole shenanigans of boxes. Alright. Now it's time to add other stuff. It's time to add enemies, of course. You know what? I'm gonna add some collision sounds to these. Sound shoot. Definitely make these a little bit quieter. This is a hit sound whenever something gets hit. And this is an explosion sound. And I actually made a box hit sound too. Because I know it's going to have boxes, lots of them. So what I'm doing is I'm adding it in any of the bullet hit events, I'm adding it so it makes that box hit sound. And then I'm going to add the sound for whenever the player shoots. And for whenever the mine explodes. So whenever this is created, it's going to create an explosion sound. So it should have like some pew pew sounds and all that fun stuff. Oh, blow this thing up. Ah, oh, that was so rewarding. Again, very, very rewarding. I'm gonna quiet it down just a little bit. Same with the box hit sound. Very, very rewarding, guys. Add sounds whenever you make games. Definitely, definitely a different experience. It's like, just waiting for those mines to go off is an experience in its own. It's like, this shoots. Oh, that was just great. Good sounds, good sounds. Very good. Very good sound. Oh. On that note, I'm gonna take a drink of water. Let's get some grubby aliens into this game. We need other things to shoot at. And I actually have some sounds from my Elite game that I would like to use. All sounds that I created myself. All done sitting at the desk.
Boom.
For instance, that. Oh, I like that one too. Yeah. Yeah, I definitely like that one.
Boom.
Alright. We're gonna use this one because it works. Start adding enemies. Who is first? Let's add like one of the basic ones. I got the tiny little worms and these things and snakes and all sorts of stuff. I like this one. Definitely gonna have to create from a strip on this one. I'm not sure what they're set up as. I don't know. 20? 30? 28? I don't know, that looked like it worked. Yeah! That actually worked. It's creepy looking. So here. I'll call this one a worm. So we got the player, we got level building, and inside a group for enemies. Alright, so basically these aliens, they have a life. Well, somewhat, so. Give these ones two. No, these ones are weak. Let's give them one health. And, PSP equals. These suckers are fast. They only have one health. Let's make them like six. And then, let's make them relatively strong. If they attacked in swarms, we could do two. Then what I did there, I'm sorry, I didn't explain that at all. This is for when he damages and does attack, it'll do two damage to the player. And then this P attacking checks if he is attacking or not. And this will allow the player to get hit. I kind of like when an enemy attacks you and they just like die on impact, and it's like you gotta shoot them before they get to you, pretty much. And I think I'm gonna go with that. So I'm not even gonna worry about that. So just when it collides with the player, it's gonna die unless the player shoots it first. So that's what I'm gonna do for that. And then I'm actually going to create, you know, like that wood thing. I have what I'm gonna call like alien bits. So I'm going to load these up and show you what they are. Let's see, under effects. It's these things. You see this? They're all like pieces of alien, and it's going to be is going to choose a random one from each and just like explode them from the alien. So I'm going to call them alien bits. And if you see here, it scrolls through a bunch of random ones, and these things are going to fly out from the alien when it dies. I don't know what they're intended for, but that's what I'm going to use them for. And then there's some guts. And then there's like, I use it for an explosion, but it's the alien guts too, so. And those will be for like the bigger ones when they explode or something. These little ones just spawn a bit or some guts. Or something, I don't know. It's just for effect. It's not, anything special. But okay, it's literally special effects, but you get what I mean. Alright. So when he's destroyed, it's gonna create all those things. And I'm gonna create a script again, which is just a duplicate of this. So it's what and how many is getting created. And you can have a global game setting for gore. Obviously, I'm not going to worry about it in this one, but I'm going to have gore, so it's going to show it, because it's not like super bad or anything. This is going to be at this X and Y position, and it's going to create... I don't have an object for it yet. Should probably stop getting ahead of myself and start designing better, Josh. Jeez. Actually, I could just use this the box exploding. This image index equals choose. I think there's five in there. Let me go back and check. It's only between 0 and 3, so 0, 1, 2, and 3. So I added one too many. So what happens is it sends it out in a random direction, or it sets it at a random direction. It changes the speed to 0 so that it doesn't scroll through all those images. It sets the image from one of those random pieces. It sets the angle at which that piece is going to end up, appearing at. It's going to throw that piece in that direction, and it's going to set the friction and get ready to destroy that piece. So that's what happens. So I'm just going to do... alien guts at X and Y. This is going to be the object alien bits, and let's create 2 for this specific object. So its health is 1 step, and I'm just going to steal it from the boxes actually. So don't even need it on that. Give loot if there is any, and then destroy it. So health is 0. Alright, let's add some to the room. They obviously do not follow the player yet, so it's okay. But how about when they spawn, we'll put them in a random direction. And then I have code to, for these things to track the players too. But I won't get to that yet. Oh, isn't he cute? He has no way of losing health yet, I just realized. It collides with a bullet. Then it loses some health and gets hit. But let's add those sounds in there. Alright, so when he gets hit by bullets, I'm just gonna steal the code from one of these boxes, put it in there, and then just subtract the health, and then play the hit sound. And it's just gonna be sound hit. And when it dies, it needs to play its crazy sound. So, play. Death sound. Enemy die. Okay. Dang it. It's solid, but I need to make sure when the bullet hits the enemy as well. I'm going to add a parent for this enemy. And the way the parents work is it can be like set on one of these aliens or something, and then you can just change the collision so when it hits the parent, instead of making it for every single one. So whenever the alien gets hit. So with a collision with the alien parent alien, then destroy it. And then we gotta give the alien the parent function. Okay. Whew, a lot of code. Alright. Let's press enter. Look how far we've come in just 2 hours. Alright, so let's just shoot the enemy. Yeah, that was cool. It was really cool how it spawned like the same object, but it won't do that all the time. And let's add some more just for testing purposes. They should all be like different directions and all stuff like that. Yeah. So. See, it's just different pieces. Lovely, huh? And we have unlimited ammo and stuff right now. Obviously, that's gonna change, but wanted to get some enemies in here. Now let's add some AI to this enemy and make him chase down the player. And like I said, I have code that I can use. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be for my enemies. There's a lot of code in here. I'm going to chop it down a lot. Let's go back to the code and have it on its step event. Oh, I guess I have to actually copy what's inside the script. Alright, so that's checking the health. Let's make another code block that moves towards the player. I'm going to add an extra slash. Three slashes allows it to show up on top. So we're going to move towards the player. Get rid of player 2. Okay. So it checks the target. If it's in sight, I need to change this. So movement, e-sight, 100 will be good. And what the p-sight's going to be, I think I said e-sight, but what the p-sight's going to be is how far the aggro range is. So if you come within 100 paces or whatever of the alien object, it'll start chasing after you. So if you're within distance, it's going to, you know, start going towards the object player at a certain speed, changing its direction towards it. Its speed's going to speed up. Otherwise, it's going to stay. And we want to get rid of this health check. Alright, so it's going to chase after the player. And then if it collides with the player, it's going to deal the damage, and then it's going to die itself. So, if it collides, first, we're going to do some damage to the player. Health minus equals P attack. So what's going to happen here is it's going to attack the player, and then it's going to kill this. So what should happen is when I spawn, everything, at least within distance, will start charging me. Oh my gosh, that was way too fast. It scared the crap out of me. Jeez. Too fast. That did scare me, I'm not gonna lie. So the whole objective of having these aliens like this is, for this reason right here, is I want to spawn a ton of these at one time, especially the smaller ones. So you just do this. And then in their code, in their step event, you want to make sure, actually when it collides with stuff, you want to make sure when it collides with a solid. So when it's colliding with a solid, or it's colliding with another alien, we want to run this code. And all it is the player's code. It's that direction. I'll show you. What it is, it's that var direction gets the direction of this against the other, and it makes sure it doesn't like run into everything. I think 5 works, and now that I look at it, I need to be using this in the player's code. Yeah, totally had it opposite on the other one. Okay. Actually, probably just change these back. So I'm going to change the player's collision back to a rectangle. Change the collide back to a 2. See what that looks like. No, that's terrible. I can only go in there like sideways. See, it just bugs it out. I think like 3 is the way to go. And then change this back. This collision stuff, I really don't like it. It's just irritating. Collision is just my worst enemy, I'm not gonna lie. I can get everything else done and working, but when it comes to this collision, it's crazy. Let's give him a smaller range there. So they don't currently get hit by the explosions either. Alright. One last test here. I can add another enemy. Or I can add some levels. I don't care. Thank you. Oh my gosh. I have an idea. In the green boxes, I need to spawn some of those enemies. I should spawn like a random amount. That'd be awesome. I'm gonna do it. I know I call them like explode and stuff like that. I should make a universal one. Just so I know what it is. So SCR, spawn objects. There. Now it won't feel so weird. Spawn that. So when you destroy the green box, you should spawn a crap load of them. Or one, I mean. That was great. Ooh. I don't know. Spawns them on top of each other. Maybe they shouldn't have collision with themselves. Like, that shouldn't matter. So, screw collision with each other. Just let them fight over who gets to come after me. They're all different speeds anyways, right? Alright, so they're all other speeds. When they spawn, needs to be a different one too. So P speed needs to be random between 3. I debugged that, my bad. Oh well. Are like almost dead, like with how slow they move. Oh, jeez. I dig that. Can handle it. All right. So this would be like arcade stage one. You know, that's kind of how that would be. All right, I have been at it again for another hour. And, you know, got a lot of stuff done again. So, let me pause this music real quick. But I hope you guys enjoy, you know, like, watching this and kind of understanding how, like, a game process is, you know, how it's made and all that kind of deal. I enjoy making games, and I know that I get stressed out a lot by, like, oh my gosh, this isn't working, or why is this code not, you know, those kinds of things. And it's tough to have to deal with those, but with Google at my fingertips, nothing is impossible. So just remember that, you guys, when you're making your games, that nothing's impossible. You just, if you can think it, it can happen. I mean, look at all the other great games out there. There's nothing stopping you. So I hope you guys are enjoying watching this, and I'm going to take quite a bit of break, but I'm not going to touch this project as much as I want to until I come back. So I will be picking up right where I'm leaving off now. Until next time, catch you guys later.